Hello viewers, welcome to Ekam Aisakal. In this video, we are going to discuss about an important concept in economy as well as fiscal federalism with respect to finance commission, that is vertical fiscal imbalance. So we'll understand what is this concept of vertical fiscal imbalance, which is recently mentioned in Hindu newspaper, right? So here you can see from the image, you can understand and decipher that something is imbalanced, right? So in that particular angle, we'll be discussing what is in terms of fiscal thing in this video. But before that, we have an important announcement regarding TGPSC Group 1 Prelims Cum Mains Foundation Batch, which is about to start from 23rd September. This course has a duration of 7 months, including 2 years validity. This will be available both online and offline in bilingual mode. This course also provides test series as well as printed study material in the form of question and answer format. The same time, entire course also you'll be getting access to daily handouts in the form of current affairs handouts, right? So along with this, you also have importantly one-to-one mentorship, which can tremendously help you in boosting your score. Along with this, we also have notable faculties who are dealing with which particular subject and all is also clearly mentioned. So for further details, you can contact us on the number displayed, right? So then what is the point of discussion? We are discussing in the context of 16th Finance Commission, which needs to tackle a major issue that is still existing in fiscal domain, that is vertical fiscal imbalance. So what is this? Let us understand. Right. First, before going into this concept of vertical or horizontal, we need to understand what is fiscal imbalance. Fiscal imbalance means when you have two ends, that is revenue and expenditure. These are the two things of fiscal thing, right? So when this revenue and expenditure are not having any proportionate level, or they're in a disequilibrium or not in balance, we call it as fiscal imbalance. That means a person, if he is having high expenditure than his revenue, that means what he's earning comparatively, if he's spending more, then we can say that person maybe is under debt and all. The same imbalance is also seen in the state governments or local governments also. So that is what we call vertical fiscal imbalance. That means, say for example, here in the context of finance commission, we need to understand generally finance commission is recommending how much of the money that center earns have to be devoluted to the states. So this is what we call as vertical devolution. Vertical devolution means out of every 100 rupees that central government earns, right? So for example, how much has to be given to the center? And you know, according to 16th Finance Commission, the recommendations are still yet to be given. But 15th Finance Commission has said 41% will be given to states. 14th Finance Commission has said it is 42%. This 1% changes because 1% is allocated to the state of Jammu and Kashmir post its reorganization, right? So this is what we call vertical. Then what is horizontal? That means after coming from the center to states, this is what we call vertical, right? So it will be divided among different states, right? So this ratio between different states is what we call horizontal devolution, right? So if you understand this concept, then it is very easy to understand, right? Vertical fiscal imbalance means when there is more expenditure than revenue, right? But when central government is giving certain things to the states or to the local governments, right? So if they're earning their revenues more and if they're spending accordingly, then there won't be much problem. Here what is happening is their revenues are falling down. They're dependent more on the state government or central government fundings, but their expenditure is very high. So this is what termed as vertical fiscal imbalance. Right? So vertical fiscal imbalance means a situation where the subnational governments or regional governments, you can say, so they are spending more than what they are actually earning. So revenue is less than the expenditure. That is the main problem we are seeing. So what is vertical? Vertical means when it is between different regions of the country. When this imbalance is seen between different regions, this is what we call, between different governments, we call it as vertical. When it is horizontal, it is between different regions of the country. Between different regions of the country, we call it as horizontal fiscal imbalance. That means the revenue is very less than the expenditure and they're more dependent on the funds from the above government. Like it can be state government or central government for fulfilling its needs. So that is a situation which is not at all good for the economy. So this is a structural problem. In case if you are augmenting the revenue more, that means if you improve the revenue sources than the expenditure, this problem can be resolved at the best. Right. So that's the thing. And let's see the practice question. Which of the following statements regarding Article 280 is correct? So you have been given four options. Try to choose which of the option is correct and put your answer in the comment section. Then, as we have reached the end of the video, today we have seen an important terminology which can be asked in prelims or upcoming prelims examination: vertical fiscal imbalance. So what is this concept and how it is different from horizontal fiscal balance imbalance we have seen in this video. If you found the video informative, do let us know in the comment section. Thanks for joining. Have a great day.